Gilly, he had to quit the shag.
Yeah.
The old shag, all the guys, they got off, they did. And you couldn't get away, they took a pipe full of the good tobacco. You said, take a pipe full, you coaxed it. Yeah, they got a pipe full of it. Then you got in your pipe and you could hear it for 2 weeks.
Was it in the pug?
No, it was in the reef.
Huh? You need a big tobacco cutter and you cut them all up and then you put, I don't know, some black strap in, some deer tongue. You need a whole mix and you mix that all in a much.
When they cut them up for maybe do a month.
The black tobacco, you know, in the States, it's cured with maple syrup. Did old Gilly grow it?
No.
They used to grow it around here, all the fields, Tom LeClaire. I watched all the French people grow it.
That's the other fellow down below the line.
French?
No. Well, I used to be there a long time ago. For a child and Larry lived.
Eh?
He lived there for child and Larry lived.
Oh, Ned Dodge.
Yeah, Ned Dodge. Yeah. My mind was stopped there one time, the table was full of it.
Yeah. Would it grow pretty good here?
Oh, I see Tom LeClaire right beside us there, who grows beside that door.
Oh, yeah.
And we mind, Clement, where Joe Scully's living, they always grew that patch for at the house there.
Did you have to plant it every year?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
But they got the leaves off it, isn't
it? It's a grow of ice
fire.
Yeah.
When that time, well then,
go to back of that.
When the toss would come on to proceed, you broke that off.
And you let it ripen, did you?
No, you wouldn't yes, but you break that seed off the top of it. Only once, maybe you keep one or two plants for seed for the next year. And then, the Tom LeClaire used to pull it out for the roots. And he'd hang it up in a dark loft, hay loft or something. And it's wet there.
Yeah.
It gets soft. But then he'd take it down in there and he'd peel it. Take the stem out of the leaf, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And then he'd roll up and twist it. And two flat stones. All those smooth, that flow. He put them all in there and put this good flat stone on top of it, with weight on top of that. Press it. You could cut it off just like any other flat tobacco. The old man LeFevre, he used to take it and bore 2-inch holes in the maple trees. And he plugged that in there and he'd drive a plug in behind it. Hard as he could drive it. And he'd leave it there till the sap was done running the next spring. And he'd fall the tree and split it to get the tobacco in. That was his wood then for the sap.
Who was this done that?
Old LeFevre. He lived where Jack McPherson is
left. The sap was going to cure it, isn't it?
Well, we practice our tune.
Yeah.
Was it tuned by it?
No, well, you could do it if you want to, but he never chewed, he smoked it. He'd be around with that long, and then he'd split it this way.
Mm-hmm.
So all the French grew their own tobacco. You could smell them for miles. Carried it, he's good. But they quit that. It takes them quite a season for it to start to freeze on them. It's sort of too early to freeze in the spring, and if they didn't show it early to freeze in the fall, they kind of quit.
Yeah.